now going to tell you the story of Sri Ganesha's birth. It's very interesting. It's very symbolic. This is Christ. That is, he is the Omega and he is the Alpha and all that they talk of. They don't know what they are talking about. It's so short form of what the whole thing is. They don't know Ganesha at all. Nothing. They just take one word here and there, just talk like that. So, he is the first one created. Now, it's very symbolic. The pure power of desire to be one with the Spirit is symbolized in the Gauri. The primordial Gauri is that power which has separated from her Lord. You can say, in her previous lives, she was separated. And again, she is born as Parvati. And she wants to be one with Shiva, which is the Spirit. So now the marriage has taken place, in the sense that now she can meet. The wedding giving has to start. But she is not yet married, in the sense that she is still a virgin, but married otherwise means she is now about to rise. Before that, she wants to have her path, because she has to meet her Lord. So she must have her bath, the bridal bath. She is a virgin, absolutely virgin. And she goes for a bath. Now, she is afraid that anybody might come inside when she is having her bath. Look at the delicacy of the whole thing. This desire, which just is meant for the Spirit, doesn't want to be exposed to anything else, any negativity coming in, anything happening. So she closes the door, but still she is worried from the back side somebody may come. So she puts this scented powder, which we use in India, for the bride specially it is given, and rubs her body with that, and she finds that a lot of it comes out. So she makes the Ganesha out of that. Now imagine how much vibrated it must be. She puts that, it's made of camphor and all these beautiful things, which are really celestial, and that is completely vibrated on her body. She makes a Ganesha and puts him at the back of the bathroom. She's having her bath nicely. At that time, Shiva comes suddenly, knocks at the door. She doesn't hear him. So he goes from the back door, there he sees Sri Ganesha sitting. He asks Sri Ganesha, "Who are you?" So he says, "I am the son of Gauri." Shiva can't understand. She is a virgin. And this one is saying, "I am the son of the Gauri." See now the Immaculate Conception. Try to understand. So Shiva says, "How can she have a child? She is a virgin." And he thinks she is bringing slander on his wife, who is a virgin. So he cuts his neck in anger and he enters into the bathroom, and Gauri is ready to receive him. And she looks out and she sees her child is dead. So he asks her, "What is this?" She said, "That's my child I created out of my this mala, what you call this, all the body things that came out, I've created him. And I put him down there. How dare you kill him?" She said, "Now what to do?" He said, "All right. What you do is to go and find the head of any animal that is available, and we will put that on this drunk and he'll be my son again. Now it's all prearranged. Because this child was not to grow into a human ego and superego business. It had to be the embodiment of childhood, embodiment of childlike innocence, because he's the embodiment of innocence. So they had to get the head of an animal. Now the wisest animal on this earth is elephant. And elephant was saved in evolution in a very miraculous way, is also another description which I'll give you later on. So a she-elephant, mother elephant, was lying down with her back towards her child. That's why in India women never sleep with their back towards their children. No, the child has to be in front, put at, in front. Should never be put at the back of the mother. Never. Mother will get up and go on the other side and change the sides, but she would never put the child at the back. So the head of that little animal was cut and he brought it and was put for Sri Ganesha. And that's how Sri Ganesha was created. But you know, elephant is the conveyance of Mahalakshmi. So the body is from Mahakali. But the head is given by Mahalakshmi, the evolutionary power. Now this Ganesha within us resides in the Mooladhara chapter.